We got Big Game Reef, Sharife Cooper. We got TC2, Taya Cooper. And we got Omar Cooper Jr. That's my twin right there. And you watching the Father's Day special on Slam. O Coop out.
Taya's like the most loving, caring person like you ever meet.
Sharife likes to sing.
Nah, you guess.
Omar likes to box. Omar is very good at boxing.
And my dad, if he see a vision, it's done. If he see a building broken down and he like what it could look like, and he say, I'ma do it, give it about 2 months and it's gonna be the most beautiful building you ever seen in your life.
And so we went to the state tournament and we was down 18 points at halftime. I told him if they win the game, we'll start an AAU team for them. You know, I still remember the look in Sharife's face. And the funny thing was playing against Ant-Man, you know, Anthony Edwards. I don't know how they did it, but you know, Omar, Isaac, Sharife, Jair, Gerard Bush, Noah Green, and they put together a comeback for the ages. And that's what started. So that summer, I had to form AOT for them.
What was my dad like? He was, while he was coaching me, you know, he liked things to go his way. So,
he hard-headed, man. He don't listen. I tell him, man, listen, bro, listen. I got a whole game plan. All right? You guard number 12. Ball go up. This man running number 3. I'm like, yo, you guard number 12. Nah, I'm guard number 3. No, you're guard number 12. I'm guard number 3. All right. 4 minutes into the game. All right, cool. You got number 3. So now he got 4 fouls in the first half. So now I'm hot. Second half, you're guarding number 12. He go out there, he's guarding number 3 again. So I asked, yo, what's up with you on number 3, man? Then I found out later that number 3 is ranked in a little fourth grade league. So I'm like, oh, okay. So, you know, just little stuff like that. But I think that's what make him who he is. I don't really think she had any bad habits that I had to fight her out of. I mean, she always went hard. She always tried to accomplish something when she took the floor. I think the challenge for her was just getting her to understand that she could play the game, because she just was not interested at all. When I finally gave up, that's when she said, Dad, I want to play. And I get, once she got a taste of it and it became a challenge for her, then that's when she accepted the challenge and she just went all the way with it. So he outside, he's shooting in the backyard, and you know, I'm looking out the window, so he playing, you know, he doing his thing, he out there shooting his shot. So I look out the window, and Sharife goes down there. So I see him, next thing I know, they playing a little one-on-one, I turn my head, Omar coming back in the house. So I said, what happened? Oh, what you doing? Why you back in the house? He said, hey, man, I just got out the shower, I tried to go outside and take a couple shots, and here comes Sharife. He all out there playing like his life depend on it, man. I just don't want to do it no more.
Sharife just real stubborn. We used to always fight a lot, so.
I'm stubborn.
Because any little thing, you just start fighting. I don't really do that no more, but back then,
it's probably like every day. Oh, yo, y'all used to be in so much competition. Sharife too, yo, because Sharife, you know, they got a new PlayStation game. O took it out the box. He plug it in. Sharife plugged the game out the wall just so he could plug it in first. I said, what are you doing, Sharife? No, that ain't how you plug it in. Took the plug out the wall just so he could be the one to box it. Yeah. It's crazy.
But me and Omar, you know, we stay in the same room. So everything was a competition. Whoever got the remote, whoever got the controller, everything. I mean, it was always fighting. So we always used to fight. We always used to, everything was a competition. Like, it wasn't even just basketball. Like, who could get to the front seat first, or who, everything.
Front seat.
Everything.
It was something about the front seat that Sharife was just ready to go to war about. I mean, nobody understood it, but it was something about the front seat that he was going to protect by all means. I mean, literally, like, what, wake up out his sleep calling front seat. Like, we had to call it. Like, the first person to call front seat got front seat. The front seat caused a lot of issues in our household.
Hey, I had to call Damon. Damon, one day y'all was in the car, and they was in the back of the car. And they just was sitting in the back, and Damon driving, and he just here in the background. He just looked through the mirror. He just hear, and he look in the mirror, and they got their hands just choking each other around the neck, just choking each other like that. So Damon like, yo, what is y'all doing? And they just stopped. I mean, they literally was choking each other like this, and then just stopped choking each other for no reason. Yeah, I tried to, put obstacles in their way. You know, like Sharife says, beauty in the struggle. I had to create struggles for them. I mean, of course, I didn't want them growing up like I grew up, but I don't even think you could make it out of that. I don't even know how I made it, but I tried to create as many obstacles, as many adverse situations for them as possible.
I feel like when one person got in trouble, we all got in trouble. I got in trouble in school for something, or maybe I had a C. I don't know what it was. But we had nice rooms, we had beds, we had all the stuff. All of it was gone. I mean, I'm talking about gone, out the room. Everybody. I think I was the only one who had a C. I think Omar Sharife was good, everybody else was good. But I got a C, and when I tell you our whole room was gone, like the whole house was just on punishment.
I think what happened was Taya got a C, and her final grade was C. This is her first C in her life. And then when I spoke to, Omar Sharife and them about it, it was kind of like, I don't see what the big deal is. So I'm like, okay, y'all don't see what the big deal is. All right, cool. Nobody won't have no bed. So now y'all gonna sleep on the floor. Cause my thing is, you gonna wear the same thing every day. You gonna eat, I don't know what they was eating, maybe. Oodles and noodles and some water. I took all the juice out the house. I took their beds and threw them away. I took their clothes and threw them away. I took all their stuff out the house and let them understand that if you're not going, humble yourself and be blessed and go to school and do the right thing, then we're going to live like nobody's going to do the right thing. So I'm not, if y'all can't hold y'all accountable as a child, then you can't hold me accountable as a dad. So you won't have nowhere to sleep. I tried to cut the lights off, but I ain't know how to do that. So I got stuck.
I mean, he still does it to this day. So, even you just can't be too comfortable. Like, he still don't like to turn on the air conditioning because I guess we living too comfortable. That it's still hot in the house. I know he can pay that bill. So I don't know. I can't live that comfortable. But like, people come over, they ask why it's so hot, but you can't touch it or it'll take it off the wall. So.
Yeah, man, that's been going for 19 years. And we only 19, so add that up.
Add it up. You just gave us the total.
Exactly.
Smart ass. I remember one time somebody said to me, if you give me a fish sandwich, I can eat tonight. But if you show me how to fish, I could eat for the rest of my life. So my main thing was teaching them how to fish. And when I feel like they're getting comfortable and they're getting complacent with me feeding them fish, they just got the wrong mentality. So if it's cool in the house and you sleeping and it's 4 o'clock in the afternoon, I got to adjust this air conditioning. I got to take this food out. I mean, I throw juice away. I throw food away. Like, Dad, I'm hungry. Are you supposed to be? You're supposed to be hungry. I mean, the more hungry you are, the bigger your appetite is. That's just my mentality. So,
even till this day.
It's between you never lose until you quit and
I'm about to say that.
If you do what you have to do, you can do what you want to do. Those are the ones that stuck to me the most, because I felt like it was true. So. I think those affected my life the most. I felt like every time I did what I was supposed to do when I was younger, I got what I wanted. So that's just what I grew up trying to do. Do what I had to do to get what I wanted. And I always don't like to hear the words no. So I figured if I did what I had to do, I could get it.
When me and Sharife went to the same school, we used to always try and go to our friend's house, like on the weekend. So we like always pull up our grades. and be like, we're doing what we're supposed to do, so can we go? And that usually led to a yes, but sometimes if we was like back-to-back weekends, he'd say no, because he can't say yes too much. But yeah, it's just...
Can't say yes too much. That is so true. I felt like you couldn't ask for something too close in time. Like, you had to wait like 2 weeks. Like, if you wanted to go to the movies 1 week, you had to wait like two more weeks to make sure you did enough good so that you could go to the movies again.
You weren't doing nothing back-to-back weeks, so.
For sure. It was something about no that just did not sit right with our souls. So we'd be like, bro, ask him. You ask. Then we just wouldn't ask, because we already knew it was going to be a no. You would say, let me think about it. And when you're thinking about it, you're thinking about your explanation to say no. So it was no point.
Oh, but again, it comes with the same old getting comfortable stuff. So if you constantly going over friend's house, you constantly indulging in the comfort and the fun, then there's a lot of work that's being left out. So instead of you trying to figure out, you know, going over your friend's house every weekend or your friend coming over here and y'all concentrating on fun, why don't you figure out how to get in the honor society? Because when you're young, that's when, you know, your creative mind is going. And you doing that and you just having a lot of playtime, then you're probably going to be by yourself a lot when you're older. And I always told them they're going to be older longer than they're going to be younger. So I felt like use your creative mind to have ingenious thoughts to be genius. Then when you get older, you could take trips with 30 of your friends, you know? You can help not your family, you can help millions of families. You understand what I'm saying? So that was always my motto. So when I seen them getting too comfortable, trying to play too much, you know, I would just shake things up because I felt like they had the DNA, the ambition, the intelligence. I felt like they had it all to be successful. And the only thing was going to stop them from doing that is them. Basically, from what I'm hearing from y'all is a bunch of madness, basically. And I'm saying to y'all that there wasn't madness. It was always a method to the madness. And now that you're a little older and you've seen some of your friends take different turns for whatever different directions, can you see at least where I was coming from when I was trying to instill these habits into y'all? Even though it was a no, you knew I was trying to save you from, you know, something worse.
Yeah, like you're not just saying no for no reason. So it was always a message to be learned or a message to be heard.
What about you, Tay?
I feel like going through all that stuff when we was little, it made us have a relationship that now, like, we didn't really need friends. Like, we had each other. We was fortunate to have each other in them times, and it just made us closer. So our relationship with each other is, like, very strong. So I think that's what was appreciative for me to be that close to my siblings and us have these stories, and we could laugh about them and we could joke about them, and we learned so much together that it just made us our family closer.
What about you, Reed?
All the lessons, well, when you say something, I like to hear why. So when we have, like, you know, we have a lot of talks and you just really explain the situation, your situation, your experiences, and then everything that led to the decision of why you told us or whatever you told us, but that's really what I like to hear. So just learning that kind of stuff, it kind of makes me feel like I understand why you said something, but I understand where you come from, so it ain't too bad for me.
Hey, I want to say happy Father's Day to all the fathers out there, and I want to say you know, a special thanks to all the kids that make great fathers, because without great kids, you don't have great fathers. So if it wasn't for y'all, who would I be? Nothing. So I appreciate y'all, and I thank y'all, and I love y'all. Peace out.
Really?